Hi everyone. Now let's see the next topic, that is a viewport. So what exactly the viewport is and where we use this viewport? A viewport is a responsive web design. So it will be used in the responsive web design applications. Responsive web design. So I already explained about this responsive web design. It's nothing but whatever the page you are going to be opened, irrespective of the device, that page will be fit to your screens. So whether you are opening in the mobile phones, tablets, and in the computer screens or even the large systems, so whatever the page, your web page you are open, that page has to be fit to that screen. That you call it as a responsive web design with the help of viewport. Okay. So with the help of the viewport element, we can display the page that should be fit according to your display screen. A viewport is a user's visible area of a web page. It is the user's visible area of a web page. So that's why we call it as a view. A viewport is a visible area of a web page. It varies with the devices and will be smaller on mobile phones than on the computer screen. So according to the screen sizes, it may be varying. So actually, before tablets, let's take in the previous days, like you are having only the computer system. You don't have the tablets and mobile phones. So in those days, the web pages were designed only for computer screens. So, and web pages have to, just like a static designs and have the fixed size. So, whatever the web page that the programmers has designed, that page will be fit in the computer screens only. So, in that way, they are designed. So, in those days, there are no tablets and the mobile phones. So, whenever the tablets and the mobile phones are started, whatever the fixed size pages that we designed previously, the programmers designed previously, they are too large to fit the viewport. Okay, so that page is too large. So with the help of the scrolling buttons, the horizontal button and the vertical button, with the help of those buttons, you're going to see the page. Okay, and the pattern is also somewhat, you'll get a congested matter. You can see the congested matter. So like that, it's somewhat not clearly visible. So to fix this, browsers on those devices scale down to the entire web pages to fit the screen. To solve that problem, we are using the viewport. So to solve that problem, you need to write a meta tag of viewport in your coding. So let's setting the viewport. Setting the viewport. How you are going to set the viewport so that the page can be opened in any of the device that should be fit on that screen. So the HTML5 introduces a method to let web designers take control over the viewport through meta tag. So with the help of meta tag, the screen size can be varied. The syntax for this is meta name is equal to, this is a viewport. Viewport and the content. So here they are writing the content as width. Let's take width is equal to, so whatever the width, that is the device width. Your screen is big or small, whatever it may be. And the initial scale, it's a zooming scale should be, let's take 1.0 by default. So this is a tag that we are writing. So where we write this meta tag, so this, it includes in the head of your HTML. So whatever the HTML document you are writing, you have to include this statement in the head section of your HTML document. So this is a meta name viewport content is equal to width is equal to device width. So based on your device width, the page will be displayed like that. Initial scale is 1.0. So here the meta name viewport element gives the browser instructions on How to control the page dimensions and scaling? It's just explain how to control page dimensions and scaling to browsers. And what about the content is equal to here width is equal to device width. It sets the width of the page depending on the device. So whatever the device you are using, depending on the device, it sets the width. And what about this initial scale is equal to 1.0? It sets the initial zoom level when the page is first loaded by the browser. So whenever the page is opened at the first time, it sets the zoom level of the page. So this is about the viewport. Thank you.